Hey folks, welcome to another Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's Tools, Tips, and Talk, where we talk about info for the knife maker. In today's episode, welding basics. Now, I don't mean forge welding, and if you're looking for forge welding, this isn't the video. We're going to talk about welding with a welder and how to stick metal together and the basics of that. If you already know how to weld, again, this video is probably not for you. This is an intro video for those that want to find out about the very basics of welding. And it's not a tutorial. Let's just give you some info and get you started. Let's take a look.
Okay, let's talk about welding. So I wanted to compare the different kinds of techniques to do welding. And if you've never done any welding, what's the easiest way for you to get into it? So let's first talk about the different types of welding. The very first kind, which I'm not even going to show, I'm not going to demonstrate, is oxyacetylene. I don't even know how to do that, and I would not recommend it. It's actually quite difficult from what I've heard. Long process, so we're going to stay away from that. The next and the easiest, cheapest to get into is stick welding. And the basics of stick welding is you're going to get a rod, a stick, which is your filler metal on the inside, and it's got a flux on the outside, and you're going to run it across your what you're trying to weld, and an arc is going to form, an electrical arc is going to form between the ground, because this is ground on one, and then you're going to be clipping this to your lead. That arc is going to be some 6,000 degrees or whatever it is. It's going to create a puddle, and the flux is going to be a shielding to prevent oxidation, and you'll get a nice weld bead if you do it right. It takes a little practice, but the good thing about stick welding, it's relatively easy. It's cheap. This buzz box, this stick welding box I got, was about $150. These rods, you can buy a whole box of them for $15 or something like that. They come in different sizes. They come in different applications, depending on if you're running AC or DC. I happen to have this plugged into 220. So it's running DC, but depending on what configuration you have. So it's easy to get into. I'll show some basics. I'm not teaching because I'm not a certified welder or anything, but I'll show the basics of what this does and the pros and cons. Then we'll get into this welder, which does a couple more processes, and I'll talk about those in a little bit. But let's first talk about stick welding. So first, equipment you're going to need. A good set of welding gloves, very important, or you're going to burn yourself. You absolutely must have a hood. Don't try the little pancake thing. They're useless. Get a hood. I think I only paid like $30 or $40 for this thing. It's an auto dimming hood. You will need for, stick welding, you're going to need a chipping hammer and a brush. Okay. We'll talk about these in a bit. Okay. So let's put down some beads and we'll see what stick welding is all about. So I happen to be using 7018 rods. I know the thickness of the metal. You'll have to look this up based on the thickness of the metal you're trying to weld, the kind of rods you're using. It will tell you the amperage that you need to set your machine at. I think I have this one set at about 124 amps, which is just fine for what I'm doing. And I'm going to be using the 1/8 inch rod. Okay, so I'll lay down a couple of beads. Again, by no means am I a great welder. I can get stuff done. So let's try it out. Thank you. I can already tell you I'm either too far away or I'm not using enough amps. So I put the amps up a little bit and we're going to try another one. So that one's a little better. I'm going to turn this machine off because it's kind of loud. Okay, so what's happening when you're stick welding is that the flux on the outside of the stick is forming a barrier here so that it's protecting the bead on the inside from oxidizing. Because if it doesn't protect it, you get these little holes here, this called porosity. You don't want that. So what you need to do then to get to see your bead is just give it a little tap and then you'll see your weld bead. Okay, that one turned out pretty good. Okay, not perfect, but they both actually turned out decent. Okay, that's basically all there is to it. Okay, and you know, you have to practice to get a nice straight line, and there's different ways to hold it and move it and speed, angle. But again, learn it, find a video that teaches you that. I'm just showing you the basics. But you could get into stick welding. You can also, this machine will also run on AC, so it's not like you have to have 220. So really, guys, no excuse not to at least get into a stick welder and learn how to weld like this. It really is a key piece of information and knowledge you need as a bladesmith. So let's go up to the next level, which could also be the first level if you want to spend the money. So by no means is this a perfect welder. This happens to be a Harbor Freight welder. It is one of their higher end models. This is the Titanium Unlimited 200. This is kind of their pro version of this series. This one does three processes. It will do stick welding like that one, but it will also do MIG and TIG. So MIG is a shielding. It is for, basically you're going to use a gun like this. You've got a very thin wire on the inside. As you press the trigger, the wire is going to feed out. Okay. When the wire contacts the piece, which is also grounded, it's going to basically complete the arc and then it will melt the wire onto the workpiece. Okay. And that's what's going to form your weld bead. Pros and cons, it's really easy because it's basically trigger. You don't need to, it's just a lot easier. You have a trigger, it starts and stops. You don't have to scratch it to get it to start. You saw me have a few problems getting the stick to start because I had to scratch it. Kind of two kinds of MIG. One is called kind of flux core, which means the wire, this is kind of dirty, but the center of this wire has flux. So it has flux in the center of it. And the wire tends to be like a silver color and it's a little thicker, but it has the flux embedded in it. You don't need gas for that. So you can get a MIG box relatively cheap, still doing it. So you're still chipping flux off of your weld bead, but the transition of it is a little easier. I have this set up with gas. Behind here is a bottle with MIG gas. Okay, MIG gas is typically 75% argon, 25% CO2. That is your typical MIG gas. The nice part of using gas is when I press the button, it's actually spraying gas from that bottle out of the nozzle. That gas is forming an inert area, so it's preventing oxygen from getting at that, which means it's very clean. I'm not chipping away any slag. There's no flux involved. It's a much cleaner, quicker process. So I'll show you that. I'm gonna lay down some MIG right along the edge here. Okay, so as you can see, that went down really quick. I went a little too fast at the beginning here, but you can see no slag to cut off. I'll do another one down here. Okay, so we can see it's a lot cleaner. I have no slag to clean up. It was really quick, painless, no spatter everywhere. I don't have to brush it off. I don't have to chip it off with the hammer. So some other aspects of this, MIG tends to be more of a kind of on the surface. You can see that the stick weld penetrates a little more. The MIG tends to sit on top, so there's usually less penetration with MIG, at least from my experience and what little I know. Stick welding penetrates quite a bit more. You can see it's kind of gone into the metal quite a bit. I probably went too fast on this one, so that's why it's bulbed up. Okay, so that's MIG. Again, if I did this with flux cord wire, I'd still have to chip it off similar to this, but it would look the same. So why do you want MIG over stick welding? Purely just because it's really easy. You can get the wire in this machine is on a big spool. It only cost me $100 to fill that tank. It lasts for hours and hours. When you're doing a lot of simple jobs, welding up billets or something, MIG is great, especially for fabricating simple things. MIG is great. Just for its speed and ease of use, which is why most people will go with MIG. I usually have this welder set on MIG all the time, and it's much easier to learn. Okay, the last and probably the most complicated, I also think it's the most fun, is TIG welding. And TIG stands for tungsten inert gas. And we're going to use this. There's a piece of tungsten here. That's going to be our lead. There's also gas coming out of here, which is 100% argon. Okay, must be argon. You cannot use your MIG mix. You have to have a dedicated bottle for this, so it's obviously more expensive. And this one is also a two-handed operation, excuse me, where you have your filler wire in one hand and you have your your lead in the other hand, and you're forming a puddle, and then you're just dipping the rod in it, and this is your filler metal. You'll notice it's a very clean, very quiet, and it looks really cool. The other nice thing about TIG is you can actually do this without the filler wire, just to fuse the two metals together. And that I use on Damascus projects where I want to fuse two pieces of metal together, but I don't want to add any mild steel. So there's definitely some uses. This one also takes the most practice, and I am not good at this one. So don't laugh at me. I'll try to lay down some beads here. Okay, that was a little better. I'll turn the gas off. Yeah, that was a little better, and you can see you can get a lot more penetration with the TIG welder. Okay, I'm also applying a lot of heat to it. So now I'm going to go back and I'm just going to do a line here, but just with fusing, no filler metal. See, that at the end is what you're not supposed to do, is dip your tungsten rod into the into what you're fusing. But anyway, I just got this, still practicing on the TIG, but that gives you the basics. By no means was this meant to be a tutorial video. This is just an intro on what the processes are.
So guys, that's basics of welding, the different processes. I hope you got something out of this. Again, this was not meant to be a tutorial, but hopefully to give you enough knowledge or oomph to get into it, so it's not so scary to get into welding. I think it's one of the most important skills you can have, and it really opens you up to be able to, you feel like you can build anything after you feel like you can weld. So get yourself a stick welder. If you don't have one, splurge for a MIG, go up to gas, play with TIG. I think TIG's really fun. I'm still learning. I'm a total novice at TIG, as you can see. But I think it's cool and I like to learn it. So I've used it on a few occasions. So hopefully you got something out of this. I had fun doing it. I love welding. I think it's a cool process to be able to do. Lastly, on today's episode, I want to give a shout out to another YouTuber that I've been watching who I think is doing some really great stuff. Ben over at Wreath and Rifle Forge. I think you should go check him out. I'll put a link or a card up to his channel up here and a link down in the description. So go check him out. He's got some really cool videos, does forging, does Damascus, very similar to what I do. So go check him out. So thanks for joining me, guys. And hopefully you got something out of today's episode, and we'll see you on the next one.